Blue check.
Light and peace in Jesus Christ our Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Gracious and loving God, we praise your name for all who have finished walking their path through this life, young and old, near to us and far away. We thank you for the gift of their lives, the grace you gave them, and the peace in which they now rest. We pray for your servants and all you have done through them. Meet us in our memories and fill our hearts with thanksgiving for the sake of our risen Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen.
Welcome to chapel at LSTC. LSTC's worshiping community is one small part of the global communion of saints, the living and the dead, gathered here for silence, scripture, song, and prayer, and you are very welcome. Today's service is special. We're gathering simultaneously on Zoom and in person to commemorate All Saints Day. All Saints is a time when we remember those who have died and reflect on the wonder, grief, joy, and other emotions that we feel surrounded by their memory. It is also a time when we claim the promise of eternal life, knowing that the saints who have died join in this banquet of life, gathering in this circle around Christ's welcome table. The prayers today will be a brief time for visiting stations around the room, where there are photos and other mementos of those who have died. The stations over by this wall also have a place to write names. At the stations, you may meditate, pray, and light candles to remember the saints who have gone before us. You're also welcome to remain where you are to pray. I'm Christian, I'm preaching and presiding today. Venetia is song leader, Lindsay is reader, and Emmanuel is worship leader and will lead us through the worship as we go.
Our song leader, Venetia, now will teach us a song.
Tidings home to care.
walls of Israel, there are angels hovering round. 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 There are angels hovering round.
A reading from Isaiah. On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will make for all peoples a feast of rich food, a feast of well-aged wines, of rich food filled with marrow, of well-aged wines strained clear. And the Lord will destroy on this mountain the shroud that is cast over all peoples, the sheet that is spread over all nations. The Lord will swallow up death forever. Then the Lord will wipe away the tears from all faces, and the disgrace of the chosen people God will take away from all the earth, for the Lord has spoken. It will be said on that day, "Lo, this is our God, for whom we have waited, so that God might save us. This is the Lord for whom we have waited. Let us be glad and rejoice in the salvation of the Lord." Word of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God.
Number 1025.
If we live to the Lord. If we die, we die to the Lord. So then whether we live, whether we die, we are the Lord. If we live, we live to the Lord. If we die, we die to the Lord. So then whether we live or whether we die, we are the Lord.
For Thou layest Thy hand upon us, in the
we sing the refrain.
If we live, we live to the Lord. If we die, we die to the Lord. So then whether we live or whether we die, we are the Lord. If we die, if we live to the Lord. If we die, we die to the Lord. So then whether we live or
A reading from Revelation. I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth had passed away, and the sea was no more. And I saw the holy city, the new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, "See, the home of God is among mortals. God will dwell with them as their God. They will be God's people, and that very God will be with them. God will wipe every tear from their eyes. Death will be no more. Mourning and crying and pain will be no more, for the first things have passed away." And the one who was seated on the throne said, "See, I am making all things new. And also, write this, for these words are trustworthy and true." Then the one seated on the throne said to me, "It is done. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end." Word of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God.
Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When Mary came where Jesus was and saw him, she knelt at his feet and said to him, "Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died." When Jesus saw her weeping and the Judeans who came with her also weeping, he was greatly disturbed in spirit and deeply moved. He said, "Where have you laid him?" They said to him, "Lord, come and see." Jesus began to weep. So the Judeans said, "See how he loved him." But some of them said, "Could not the one who opened the eyes of the blind man have kept this man from dying?" Then Jesus, again greatly disturbed, came to the tomb. It was a cave, and a stone was lying against it. Jesus said, "Take away the stone." Martha, the sister of the dead man, said to him, "Lord, already there is a stench because he has been dead 4 days." Jesus said to her, "Did I not tell you that if you believed, you would see the glory of God?" So they took away the stone, and Jesus, looking upward, said, "Father, I thank you for having heard me. I knew that you always hear me, but I have said this for the sake of the crowd standing here, so that they may believe that you sent me." When Jesus had said this, he cried out with a loud voice, "Lazarus, come out." The dead man came out, his hands and feet bound with strips of cloth and his face wrapped in a cloth. Jesus said to them, "Unbind him and let him go." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
My wife, Pierrot, and I don't often go to the movies. Not that we don't love seeing film on a big screen, but the pandemic shifted our patterns, and the ease of curling up on the couch in our living room eating our own relatively inexpensive homemade popcorn is what usually outweighs going out to a theater. But when I saw that a favorite actor, Ralph Fiennes, famous for playing He Who Shall Not Be Named in the Harry Potter films, was in a new movie, we had to go. And along with being a favorite lead actor, the film Conclave is about the election of a new pope, an entire film about a central feature of global Christianity. Come on, I could go have fun and get credit for continuing education. Fiennes plays Cardinal Lawrence, the dean of the College of Cardinals. Upon the pope's death, cardinals gather from all parts of the globe in Rome. The conclave, as it is called, takes place in the Sistine Chapel, and the cardinals are sequestered until a candidate receives enough votes to become pope. As the ELCA will soon see in its own election of a new presiding bishop, such elections are often political, filled with ambitious candidates who jockey for support. In his opening homily for the conclave, Fiennes, as Cardinal Lawrence, addresses the solemn assembly, all arrayed in their white mitres and their beautiful red copes. Speaking at first in Italian, in measured and formal tones, he addresses the great uncertainty of this moment in the history of the church and asks God's guidance on the choice before them. But then, pausing, he looks down at the lectern, he takes off his glasses, looks out, and says in English, "Let me speak from the heart for a moment." He speaks of the danger of certainty, suggesting certainty is the great enemy of unity. If, he says, there was only certainty and not doubt, there would be no mystery, and therefore no need for faith. Let us pray God will grant us a pope who doubts. Well, it was quite a thriller of a movie with all the intrigue and plot twists to keep a viewer engaged. It was that moment that hit me in the gut, how present doubt feels to me in this moment. As I meditated on the beautiful passage from Isaiah and its echo in Revelation, I found myself doubting their claims. I found it hard to hear the word all again and again, all peoples. For all nations, Isaiah writes, making all things new, John writes in Revelation. Where, I ask, show me where this is true. These promises are hard to hear in the face of bracing winds of personal grief and loss. Many in our community have lost a beloved family member, a friend, a mentor, or someone close to us has. We carry them with us as we gather this day. We know their names. We know the ache losing them leaves with us. These promises are hard to hear given the geopolitical storms of division and hatred and violence swirling in this nation and around the world. We come with very concrete sorrow today, very real worry about the election next week. We worry about its consequences for us, yes, but also for the most vulnerable, not only across this nation, but beyond our national borders. My doubts about the promises so glowingly offered in these texts leads me to the utterly human Jesus as he approaches the home of Mary, Martha, and their brother who has died, Lazarus. John tells us slowly, achingly, of Jesus' reaction. He is disturbed in spirit. He is deeply moved, and he weeps. I invite you to linger here and not rush to the conclusion of the story of Jesus and Lazarus. When John writes in Revelation that the home of God is among mortals and that God will dwell with them, that they will be God's people and God will be with them, it also means this. Jesus, disturbed by suffering and death, moved by our grief, and with us in our weeping when circumstances seem overwhelming, when they seem literally unbelievable. Don't we too cry out like Mary, Lord, if you had only been here? And yet in her doubt, her frustration, her grief, her confusion, and in ours, Jesus is here with us in our mourning. In our doubt, in our grief and anxiety and fear, we do, as Cardinal Lawrence put it in his homily opening the conclave, need faith. We do not have certainty upon which to lean, exhaling, finally at ease, that all which has gone amiss is now set right. Faith allows us to face the hurt and harm in our lives of the world and say, God is with us in our suffering. Yet God desires for our lives to be otherwise. And here the texts both promise and practice insofar as they paint a vision of how God's otherwise world should be. The promise comes as a foretaste of that otherwise world here, gathered around a table with the saints, living and dead, joining in a feast in which all are fed the bread of heaven, all receive the cup of salvation, mercy covering all, each embraced by a peace that passes all understanding. And the practice comes as we too are freed from all the ways death and grief and fear bind us, just as the strips of cloth bound Lazarus. Jesus says to us, to you, unbind them and let them go. We go from here into the world God loves to live as people unbound, practicing resurrection, living in God's otherwise vision, where indeed all things are made new. Amen. With all the saints, we confess our faith in the ancient words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
We will now take a few minutes to remember those we love who have died. Offer our prayers. First, we will learn a song together from Venezia, and then you are invited to continue singing as your prayer. Remain in your seat or visiting the table to write out memories or names of departed loved ones on the paper. You may also bring up photos or other memories you have brought with you. Place them on the altar. Those on the Zoom are welcome to type names, memories, and prayers into the chat box.
Receive, O earth. 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 Receive, O
receive all.
We'll bless our meal in the patterns of ancient Eucharistic prayers. Venetia will lead the sung responses. We pray with our hands lifted, as was the custom in the early church.
Please rise. Venetia will be singing your line, and you echo back what you hear from her. May God be with you.
And also with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Holy One.
We lift them to the Holy One.
It is right to give God thanks and praise.
It is right to give God thanks and praise.
It is right to give God thanks and praise.
Holy God, we give you thanks for your holy name, which you planted in our hearts, and for the knowledge, faith, and immortality you sent us through Jesus, your child.
Glory to you forever and ever.
Glory to you forever and ever. Glory to you forever and ever. Glory to you forever and ever.
You created everything, mighty Lord, for the glory of your name. You gave us food and drink for our pleasure, and that we might give you thanks. You have blessed us with spiritual food and drink and eternal life through your child. Above all, we thank you because your spirit moves among us even now.
Glory to you forever and ever.
Glory to you forever and ever. Glory to you forever and ever. Glory to you forever and ever.
While Jesus was eating with his disciples, he took a loaf of bread, and after blessing it, broke it and gave it to them, and said, "Take, this is my body. Do this in remembrance of me."
Glory to you forever and ever.
Glory to you forever and ever. Glory to you forever and ever. Glory to you forever and ever.
After supper, he took a cup and said, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this in remembrance of me."
Glory to you forever and ever.
Glory to you forever and ever. Glory to you forever and ever. Glory to you forever and ever.
Mother, with this bread and cup we remember your child Jesus, dwelling with us, making us abundant fields of wheat, vines laden with ripe fruit.
Christ has died, Christ is risen, Christ will come again.
Christ has died, Christ is risen, Christ will come again.
As grain was scattered across the hills, then gathered and made one in this bread, so send your spirit that your church scattered to the ends of the earth may be gathered and made one in your commonwealth.
Amen, amen,
food for holy people. Share in the meal. At LSTC, all are welcome to receive communion. An usher will invite you forward to receive communion. If you would like an individual cup, take one at this time. You'll first receive vegan gluten-free bread, which you may eat immediately. At the first station is a common cup with grape juice, which you may drink from. The second station is a pouring chalice, also with grape juice, which they will pour into your cup. Then please return your individual cup to the basket on this table over here. If you do not wish to receive communion, you are welcome to remain in your seat or to come forward with arms crossed on your chest to signal you would prefer a blessing.
We will sing from the Red Book, number 466.
Body of Christ broken for you.
We'll sing our final hymn for all the saints, hymn number 422 in the ELW. Then we will conclude the service by sharing a sign of peace with one another. After sharing the peace, you are invited to depart quietly or to remain to quietly pray.
Divine, we
divinely live in peace, and the God of love and peace will be with you. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Amen.
Amen.
The peace of Christ be with you all, always.
And also with you.
In a ways that feels comfortable, bearing in mind that some enjoy hugs while others prefer a wave or a bow, please share a sign of God's peace with your neighbor.
Peace be with you.
God's peace.
Peace be with you. Peace be with you.
God's peace.
Peace be with you. Does it happen? No, we should though. Oh, you do.
Thank you so much, as always.
Okay.